Come on. Tug of war. Tug of war. Puppy dog and Brendan. Pull it, Brendan. Pull it.
Brendan still is a happy toddler with energy to spare.
He keeps me really busy.
Yeah.
He's just loves to climb up the slide. He doesn't even climb up the ladder. He climbs up the slide. And he doesn't really seem to tire.
But Brendan's energetic behavior hides a serious problem. At 10 months old, Brendan caught a cold, and his parents took him to the doctor. During the visit, the pediatrician listened to his heart and heard something unusual.
And I remember sitting in the waiting room thinking, okay, I just got to get this over with. It's a formality. They did the echocardiogram, and the doctor said, there's something going on. She said, his heart is not normal.
That day, Brendan's parents learned that their son had a rare, complex heart defect. He was born without a main pulmonary artery and was missing the valve that normally connects this artery to the heart.
Brendan has tetralogy of Fallot and pulmonary atresia. What's important in that is that the pulmonary artery did not grow adequately, so that there's a blockage from the heart to the lungs. Blood cannot get from the heart to the lungs.
If left untreated, babies with this condition often do not survive their first year of life.
I had an older sibling who was born with this defect, and she died in her third or fourth week of life. She didn't make it.
Knowing the severity of his condition, Jennifer and David brought little Brendan to the best place for treatment, the Heart Institute at Children's Hospital Los Angeles. Brendan was prepped for open heart surgery, where a donor valve created a temporary connection between Brendan's heart and lungs. Brendan recovered quickly, but after 7 months, he outgrew the implant. Now, he needs another surgery, but this time it will be more complicated. Brendan will undergo two procedures. First, catheterization, and next, open heart surgery.
How's he doing?
He's doing well.
Dr. Frank Ng, world-class pediatric cardiologist, meets the parents to discuss the procedure, in which he and his team will widen key blood vessels in Brendan's lungs to allow for more blood flow. The procedure is necessary to prep Brendan for the open heart surgery that is to come.
Dr. Ng has been doing this for several years, and he is doing something that is very difficult to do.
With the procedure just moments away, David and Jennifer wait with Brendan as Dr. Ng and his team assemble in the cath lab. Using an approach called cardiac catheterization, Dr. Ng will push catheters up a vein and into the heart and lungs to widen narrow vessels deep in Brendan's lungs. In order to do this, he must use specialized tools to prepare the catheters for this extremely delicate procedure.
So basically what we're doing is using this heat gun to heat this up a little bit and to change the curve of this catheter.
Relying on x-rays, ultrasounds, and contrast dye, Dr. Ng and his team map out a route to get to the narrow vessels in the lungs.
The size of his heart is the size of his fist, and trying to cross through these valves and chambers can be dangerous, so we have to be very careful.
These intricate interventions require highly magnified images.
You have to translate what you see on the screen, which can be inches in size, into your fingertips, which is going to be millimeters as you manipulate.
Keeping his eyes trained on the monitors, Dr. Ng navigates up Brendan's vein to the heart.
Okay, see that? See that right there? That's where their entrance is.
The work is painstaking. Brendan's vessels are tiny, and one false move could tear them open. To hold the vessel open, Dr. Ng prepares a stent made out of metal mesh.
So this is a metal band here that is mounted on the balloon that's going to go into the area of narrowing. We're going to expand the balloon. The stent is going to span against the wall of that vessel, and when we take down the balloon, the stent will stay in place to hold it in place.
Slowly and carefully, Dr. Ng eases through the heart valves and across the heart. Now he moves millimeter by millimeter into a vessel that needs widening.
Okay, this should slide in. Oh, look at that. Now you should start further in because I always pull back, I can't push forward.
When you're dealing with babies, it's another degree of difficulty because they're much smaller, the curves are much tighter, the vessels and everything else in the body is much more fragile. So there's a fine balance between how hard to push. It takes a lot of training. I went through 9-10 years of training to get to the point where I can at least do this kind of procedures.
Go on up, go. Go to 14, tell me when you're there.
14.
Go to 15.
16.
Okay, good, we'll stop. And leave it like that, there it goes, beautiful.
Dr. Ng labors for hours in the cath lab, opening up small blood vessels so Brendan's heart will be able to send more blood to the lungs for oxygenation. The results are remarkable.
So here is the picture after our stent procedure. Here's the stent. And now you see how much blood goes in there. Now you see how all the smaller branches are getting blood flow. It's a lot better than what it was before.
Hi. Well, everything went very well. I'm very happy with the results we got because the flow to those lower lobes are much better than what we had before.
With Brendan's procedure a success, now it's his parents' turn to breathe more easily.
I feel very lucky that I really have a passion for this. But I have to say, at the end of the day, after I'm finished and I have a good result, it feels very gratifying. And so I enjoy my work.
As Brendan recovers, his parents are grateful for the successful outcome. But their son is not out of the woods just yet. A few weeks later, Brendan returns to Children's Hospital Los Angeles for his open heart surgery. The procedure to implant the new pulmonary valve is headed by lead surgeon Dr. Vaughn Starnes, a preeminent cardiothoracic surgeon who has pioneered many expert techniques in pediatric heart and lung surgery.
It's very rewarding. You can take a baby that's blue that morning and come by that afternoon, he's warm and pink, and you know he's got a great life in front of him.
Even though David and Jennifer have been here before, surrendering your child for major surgery is never easy.
All right, love you, buddy. Ready? All right, they're gonna take good care of you. There we go.
All right. Go to downstairs first floor.
Okay, and get a major.
Go to the CTICU wing.
Okay. Okay. Thanks.
I think the challenge with children is that their anatomy every time can be different because it's congenitally determined. So it allows you to be somewhat creative every time you open the chest to correct a lesion. It allows you to do creative things, construct three-dimensional patches to make reconstructions with.
Now it's time to implant the new pulmonary valve. And for that, Dr. Starnes and his team must stop Brendan's heart. Time is of the essence.
You can stop the heart for a finite period of time before the heart undergoes injury. So you want to be as efficient as you can and limit the amount of time the heart is stopped and also the amount of time the baby's on the heart-lung machine.
While Dr. Starnes and the team work on Brendan, Jennifer and David wait to see their child again. Working quickly but diligently, Dr. Starnes installs the new valve in a matter of minutes. And as if nothing ever happened, Brendan's heart begins to beat again, this time with a new pulmonary valve providing increased blood flow to the lungs.
Surgery went very well. We were able to accomplish all the things that we wanted to do.
Thanks to Dr. Starnes, Brendan won't need a new pulmonary valve for at least 10 years.
Brendan now has a totally reconstructed pulmonary tree. He's got normal pressures in his lungs, so his life expectancy should be quite normal.
How's he doing?
Hey, buddy.
Is he good? Hey, sweetie. Hey, baby.
While he'll need to be monitored and have occasional procedures to keep up with his growth, Brendan is expected to live a normal life and Children's Hospital Los Angeles will be there helping him every step of the way.
We are really fortunate to live where we live because we have access to these people who are really rock stars in their field. And it's something to be thankful for.
One thing that we've always been grateful for here at Children's Hospital Los Angeles is how wonderful they treat everyone.
Working at Children's Hospital, it's a great institution. It's very supportive of my work. It's very supportive, more importantly, of the children and all the things that we need to do to care for the total child and the family.
We have some of the best surgeons in the country here doing operations here, and that's one of the reasons why I joined this team.
When all is said and done, he's going to live a normal life, and he's going to have all of the possibilities that other normal kids have in front of them. And that's thanks to Children's Hospital and the team that works on him here.